Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. Now, we've got one, Arcane de Nuit and all that, but is it Arcane de Nuit? It's the Green King, I believe. I don't think they're Arcane de Nuit, but I think they kind of run him. But it's Bellhaven, which is up there, Arcane de Nuit and all that. So, oh, flower, Scotland and all that. Original Scottish craft. And since 1719, Dunbar, Scotland. Let's have a little read. Let's have a little quick read. Here we go. Bellhaven, or beautiful harbour. I nearly called it Berlin. Sorry. Behave. Bellhaven, or beautiful harbour, settles among the rolling barley fields of Scotland. Scotland's beautiful east coast. For nearly 300 years, we have brewed in that place using only the finest local ingredients. Good. Continuing that long tradition, this range of speciality beers. Each has its own unique taste and style. Together they represent the very best of Scottish brewing. Lovely. On the bottom here it says our signature Scottish ale is the beer we've brewed the longest and is our best-selling bottle worldwide. We brew it from 100% Scottish optic and crystal barley malts. For like I said before, I think optic malts, I think he's one of those, got Golden Promise and optic malts and things like that, one of those that they use to make the wash for making the whiskey with. I could be wrong. Crystal barley for malty biscuit character, balanced with a subtle spiciness from Challenger and Golding's hops. Lovely. They've listed the hops for a change. That is very, very, very good. For an all-round satisfying beer. George Hell, Master Brewer, Bellhaven. That is lovely. That's good. More people should do that. List the stuff on there. And 5.2. Yes, in a little one, little 330, but 5.2. It hasn't stopped on 4.8, which too many breweries seem to go. I think there's a crossover point into another tax or something like that, tax relief or whatever it is, and they go 4.8, wallop, stop. Everyone that was 5.2s before has gone, just rein it back to 4.8, and all that. And some you don't notice, but some you do, you know. And I just don't like the idea of reining things back. It's like a mighty pint and that. We get bottles now that are, instead of 568, are 500 mils. Used to get 568 mil size bottles. Back in the good old day when I was, you know, a wee nipper and taking the bottles back for dad and things, you know. And there is the old thistles there, the old thistles. Lovely little thistle, the floric emblem, I believe, of floral. Emblem of Scotland, I believe. I've always thought it should be the old heather and everything, but I don't know. What does that look like? But it's been put on hats and things, and you know, and kilts and whatever else throughout the years. Now, shall I pour the lot in? Just leave it there. Leave it there. Pour it short. Now we got a nice little fluffy head, big bubbles. You got again bronzy sort of mahogany look. That's very nice going through there. Gentle carbonation. Nice. Looks very nice with the light going through as well. Sometimes I don't like beers to look too clean. It sounds rotten, but I like beers to look a little bit like there's something in there. And that looks really clean. It looks like ting. Like they've got it out, polished it and everything, and put it back. You know. But there you go. What am I expecting? It smells delightful. It smells lovely. It does smell very biscuity. Oh, it smells lovely. Really, really lovely. Smells malty and biscuity. It smells like what's them ones with the picture of the cow and all that on? Malted milk. Malted milk biscuits it smells like. Do you remember them little brick sort of shapes? And they had a little picture of a cow on them. I think they said malted milk across it as well. Very much malted milk biscuits in there is basically what you're getting. Those little vanilla-y sort of notes in there. Malty notes. Just pure malted barley notes. And then you've got tiny little speckles of fruit just ping every now and again, like shooting up your nose. You know, like when if you've got orange peel and you bend it and sort of squeeze it a little bit and roll it around in your fingers, and you get little fountains of coming off the surface, little fountains of zest. There's zest oils. It's like every now and again you get just one of them goes up your nose a little bit. And it is in bits because you get like a big waft of all the malted milk biscuits. And then, oh, where did that come from? And it sort of shoots away, and then, oh, another bit. And it seems to just pop up every now and again. Maybe as a bubble comes to the surface or something, I don't know. But it seems to up you. Yeah, very cute. Right, let's jump in. Cheers. I don't know why I keep scratching. I've got fleas. Sorry, I ain't. Cheers everyone, bottoms up, I've got crabs. sorry. Listen, I'm gonna go into depths here, I'm gonna be naughty. Speaking from an expert in gynecology and stuff like that, if you ever find yourself with crabs or something like that, right, what you should do is you rub honey and syrup into the region, the pubiscus regionality there, right? Well, so you know, it's kind, it's, you know, it's not naughty or horrible, it's quite kind and gentle. It doesn't kill them, but it rots their teeth and you'll have a good night's sleep. Sorry, I'm gonna get so kicked out of the beer bloggers union. Sorry, everyone. Can I come back now? Cheers, everyone. Chin chin. Stop it. Right, serious. Oh man. That is beautiful. That is really beautiful. One thing to do if you're having trouble tasting like that, half of your lungs, right, get it up there like that. So while it's there, go half of your lungs, the other half, hold, tip, swallow. Breathe that out through your nose. So, no, all right. So I go, all right. And all the lot goes together because you can't taste nothing. Try this as an experiment. Block your nose up. Put something up your nose. Block it and taste, and then go back out of a bottle though, so you don't get some of that in your mouth, because you mustn't, you've got to try not to, and don't breathe out, just like that, out of a bottle, with that covered, like holding your nose, and don't breathe out, just taste it, and go, I can't taste hardly anything, and then breathe it out, and suddenly you go, ah, I know what Terry's on about now. Cheers. Oh man, that is gorgeous. Now, weird little thing. You've got little whiskey notes in this. You've got little whiskey notes, little sugar notes. It's kind of like whiskey and sugar, whiskey and brown sugar notes in there. As if you've, see some people put whiskey and sugar in their coffee. I put whiskey in my coffee quite often. But I don't use sugar anymore, so you don't get that sugar mixture. But it's lovely. Sugar, if you have sugar in your coffee, put a little spot of whiskey in there. And instead of using white sugar, get like muscovado's, demerara sugars, try different sugars. Muscovado sugar in coffee. Like I say, I don't have sugar anymore, so I've kind of lost the love of it, lost the flavour of it in there, you know, in coffee, certainly, you know. Pardon me. You got the malted milk biscuits on the tongue. A little hint of whiskey and demerara sugar, and tiny little notes of like breakfast juice, you know, the grapefruit, oranges, and a bit of lemon, but tiny and quite sweet, sweetened up, you know, like almost to having a chew sweet with it, you know. A sort of sweet, but a tiny little hint, just a little hint in there. As if you've just sprinkled some of that on your top of your thing and that. It's got a flavour of old beers in there as well, that old kind of fudgy sort of flavour. That's really nice. That is a really, really nice beer. Well, let's pour the second half in and see if we've got any yeast in there. Nope. Right. Bum 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 bum. That is beautiful. Try it, buy it, and love it. Let me know what you think. But I really think try it, buy it, and love it. I paid for it today. In B&M's, I paid two of them for 18. I paid 89p each for these. 89p. Got two of them for £1.78 or whatever it was. 89p each, that's ridiculous, isn't it? People are still buying McLagers. 89p each, it's bloody gorgeous. I nearly said fucking gorgeous then. But it's bloody gorgeous. So, excuse me with being rude and everything, but you know, I just tell it how it is and everything. That is exceptionally lovely. Go out and buy it. Or else, okay, I don't know. Cheers. Slaughter. For the man to wait, with the man.